Passenger eject button.
Channel, we're here at SMS Design and Performance with a Z in the background because today we're gonna be starting this car.
Finally. Taking some time, but you know, finally the turnkey moment has arrived.
Yeah, we got Majid working on the electronics. I'll be showing you a little bit more of that in detail, why it's been taking so long, as well as how much work everyone here has been putting into this build. Especially this guy over here who's been the main designer throughout the whole process. We haven't agreed on a lot of things, but in the end, I think it was all worth it. Would you like to say something to the camera?
Something to the camera.
Amazing. I'm gonna get fuel, let's do this. Alright, so here we have a quick look of the wiring before it goes into the car. And Majid, would you like to explain what's going on here? I see heavy duty wiring stuff going on, but you probably can explain it better.
So what we have here is the whole harness that's going to go in the car. So this is the engine room. This is the engine room side. That's the rear light side and the fuel pump. Plus we have one somewhere here hidden underneath that goes to the driver. And what we have here is just what we call a final bench testing verification. Just we make sure, you know, everything works. We have it connected here just like we'll have it connected on the car. So we'll have, you know, proper body.
So if you press the pedal, opens up the throttle body, and you can check out the revs right there on the race pack.
We have a simulator, so, you know, simulates the engine running. So that, you know, give us the advantage of, you know, mapping the or pre-mapping the engine.
So fuel gauge is also connected right now, testing it over here.
We're calibrating the fuel level gauge as well, so, you know, it's connected to the race pack and, you know, it shows you the level. Normally we have like 15%, wherever it goes below 20, you should worry.
Okay. And then over here we got the fan that's gonna cool the fridge.
Yeah, we'll have two of these, but, you know, right now it's connected, you know, just as a test with the throttle body. We have the relays here. With a 3D printed bracket, you know, these relays comes, you know, like a kit, you know, like a Lego kit, where you can wire them up and, you know, make them work in any way you like, you know, trigger them by positive, negative. It's going to sit nice and neat, and actually no one going to see them. All this hard work for, you know, just to be hidden away. So switch panel is next.
Okay.
Yeah, and they need to bring the fridge back from powder coating. So when it comes back, we start, you know, putting everything back together. We're doing the battery cables, you know, the light wires on the car. We'll wrap up the harness tonight. We'll finish off, you know, shrink tubing, gluing. So it's all sealed. It's all, you know, waterproof.
Oh, she's on this lift now.
Yes.
What are you doing, man?
Oh, for a hand the brake.
The e-brake.
Hand the brake and
oh, we have a look at the new rotors.
Yeah,
these ones are nice, no? These brakes?
Yes, it's a new one, no?
Yeah, this new one, but China. Looking all shiny on the lift brake calipers. I have been painted in that second, like, off-gold color. All right, so connectors now are looking really nice and tidy. So these are shrink boots around the connectors, just making sure all the cables are safe. These connectors are airplane grade. They're tough as nails, and this is stuff that Majid has been telling me that Corsair does for airplanes. So that's pretty high-tech stuff, you know. Wiring is is black magic to me, as I said, but I mean, we got the right person on the job here.
It's custom made, tailored for whatever needs they have. So Snowcart has a, you know, a different need, so.
Yeah, if you can see that, some badass shit is coming. So everything here is labeled as well, so it's easier when unplugging and dealing with this later for Majid, because
yeah,
he's going to be...
it's an idiot-proof wire harness. This loom actually has a few stuff more built into it that actually we don't need it right now. Like, for example, we have a boost solenoid output, you know, even though we don't have a turbo, but, you know, it's just there for a future. Just in case you guys want to do a turbo, we can still, you know, convert this to a V8 to run a 8-cylinder, you know, any type of engine. We can redo it if you want to have a V12 if you want or a V10. But yeah, I mean, we kind of over-engineered it or overbuilt it in a way. So, you know, if we want to do something else in the future, you know, it's all there. It's all built into it.
And here's the death cart, Bugsy. Got brake lines going on. Pretty much everything is fit. What else is new? Wiring going through the cage, as well as we got some lights here at the back. So just some small lights, because they're required by a lot of events that happen around this area. And yeah, there's more brake lines for the e-brake that's gonna go in. And yeah, pretty much done. It's just wiring, just making sure everything is done properly right the first time. Yeah, it looks sick, man.
That looks really good.
Oh, so they painted this as well. Nice. So this is basically gonna connect to the firewall. All the connectors are there. This is for the battery. It's been painted. Now Majid is trying to put everything together, make sure it's all in here, all hidden. But still, he's doing a great job. Oh, look at this. This is the shroud for the fan, painted as well. Looks sick. A couple of bits and pieces, and then we're gonna fire up the car. So here's a look of the car underneath while the guys are working on it. Just tightening all the bolts and everything, making sure it's set, kind of. And I'm gonna start from the back. The exhaust system that was countless times changed and everything, so it sits perfectly straight. And everything underneath is also painted, so everything from the diff and the exhaust sitting exactly, you know, with enough space here between, and it's solid here with a custom mount connected to one of the braces underneath. Drive shaft and the transmission painted as well. And there's like an off paint. This is one of the paints we were thinking about painting the whole car, but it was a bit too rich, so we kind of like shot it on, you know, different parts. You can see the headers there. The whole exhaust was actually built here for the most part. This part is the only part we ordered, these headers. And we were looking for like a nice white pipe and couldn't find one. So this was made in house. This was also made in house. Everything down here was made in house. And yeah, it looks absolutely sick. Only the muffler we got from Remus, just to make sure there's enough back pressure. And we're still looking for a second brake caliper for the hydraulic system. But yeah, it's pretty much almost done.
Okay. You have basically two switch panels. I call this one your engine control panel, and you know, your accessory panel. So this panel handles everything that has to do with the engine or basically driving the car. So you'll have your ignition switch, fuel pump, water pump, logging or data logging switch. Dash switch is to flip the dash page, so you have multiple dash pages, fan one, fan two, an ejecto seat. And we have the start button in here.
You know, sick.
That's your engine start.
Carbon fiber start button.
Yeah, it's all 3D printed. It's all done here in house.
I mean, look at this job. I mean, this is like everything in place, looking really neat and tidy.
On this side, basically we have, you know, the ECU sits kind of this way.
And the ECU has the fan shrouding that was made here.
Yeah, we
Maj's design.
Yeah, I designed this machine.
Sick.
It's all in here. Then we have the ECU kind of sandwiched in between. We made these riser blocks, so you know that would give us some extra clearance.
So here you got the extra clearance. You got the fans to cool down. Yeah. The fans will kick in at a certain temperature.
Yeah, the fan would use is the ECU internal temperature sensor to get triggered. So whenever the ECU gets hot, you know, it knows it and, you know, it switches the fans off.
Sick. Because earlier you had them connected to the pedal, but now they're programmed to just kick in when the internals get hot in the Haltech.
I had them programmed to the pedal just, you know, for testing purposes, just to see, you know, if everything actually functions. It's all been bench tested. You got me the expander, so we're working on that. You know, we're doing the expander harness.
So we needed the expander basically for the extra switches that we have, because my kind of decision was to have as many switches as possible and feel like a fighter jet. But Majid has done, you did the ignition. Can you just run me through that?
So basically what we have is, we have the all the channels in the computer is fully occupied by, you know, drive-by wire, fuel pressure and other stuff. So that didn't leave us any spare channels. So we added the expander. So the benefit of that, we can have, you know, extra sensors like, you know, oil temperature, and whatnot. But, you know, the main purpose is to have some extra inputs and control over the car. So basically we added those two trim switches
here.
So you have one which is four position, and we have one that goes all the way to 11 position. So what that one allows us to do is we can actually tune this car on the fly. So we can have this switch to add more fuel or more timing or more boost, use it as a boost controller. Or you can actually even use it to control the fan speed. You know, the sky is the limit. You can have this, you know, as your fuel control, where, you know, it adds more fuel, it throws more fuel, you know, it retches the engine. And this one can control the ignition timing. So, you know, you add more fuel and less timing, and that equal more
flame.
Bang. All you have to do is just flip the ignition on, hit the start button, it should run. Switch it off, it should go off.
Meanwhile, Casper is here, checking it out.
Ejecto. Ignition. Yeah. What other interesting?
Boom.
What other interesting letters do we have? Nothing. Fire, ALS, Wi-Fi.
So yeah, you have these spare switches, so you can have, you know, some manual override over the car, so you can have the water pump and the fan running in the pit just to cool it down. Or you have it running. You have the fuel pump running just to empty the fuel tank. Basically, this is your data log switch, so, you know, whenever it's out, it's on, the ECU is recording everything that's happening.
Sick.
You know.
So that's probably always going to be on, because you will want it to be on
much,
to see
pretty
it.
Pretty much, yes. Yeah, yeah. I mean, every time you're beating on the car, just make sure it's on, so at least we know what kind of stupid shit you
did. Why it blew up.
Okay, my question to you is, do you want me to engrave this with an engine start, or should I put my signature in there?
Put your signature.
100%.
I'll sign it then. I'll sign it, then you show it to YouTube. So
sick.
YouTube what my signature look like. So you can go and steal my bank account.
that could be useful for future reference.
This, to me, is absolutely like next level shit, man. Like all of this, like there's no one part I like more than another, because everything is just so cool. This was also built in-house. These, you know, this plastic holder for the expander.
These switches actually came from a Nitro's kit. These switches usually goes on the throttle. They call it full throttle switch. And you know, we usually change them because they can't stand high vibration and high abuse and high heat. For this application, to make it even more reliable and redundant, I've used two. So if one fails, you can still have the other one actually function. And you have two opposite to each other, so if you press it from the top, it triggers. If you press it from the bottom, it triggers. Side triggers, like, so it works in all positions.
Oh, I didn't even think about that, but yeah, you're right. Because sometimes when
I designed it in the first time, they were pointing at the same time, at the same side, and it didn't actually work properly. Like, you have to press it on one side to actually function. But you know,
and you change the. Yeah, that's a nice feel.
Yeah, he changed the spring.
He changed the spring.
Yeah, listen.
You know what he had?
The whole thing is nice, but these switches are chintzy as f***. man. Like, they don't even have washers, man. I hate those switches, honestly. Like, that's the cheapest thing we have in the
world. One thing I really like, it says SMS on the button on the back. That's something pretty much nobody will ever see, but it's there, you know, just like original parts. They always have a serial number or something. This one has it too. Quick look at everything installed right now. As you can see, Majid has disco mode, I think. And here you can see everything neatly installed. This is the service light, as you said.
Yeah.
And you control the lights with this switch over here. So if you turn it, so I turn it once, it'll turn on disco mode. One more time, it's just like this fan on mode with the lights in the back. And then this is off, right? So one is off.
This is actually auto mode.
So auto mode.
It uses the temperature sensor inside the ECU. See how much the temperature is, and it switches the fans on the last record.
So I can never turn it automatically off by mistake or something like that. It's always on.
It'll run by itself.
Okay.
It's an idiot-proof system.
It's me-proof. Okay. So I have, like, the switchboards are installed. Over here is a little plaque in carbon fiber built by SMS Design and Performance, 2019 carbon fiber. I like that. And this is the push start button. This is what you guys use a lot in
That's my signature. You said I can sign it.
Yeah, that's cool. So this is like Majid's signature here. Missing one tooth.
Yeah. Well, I have all of them. Yeah, it has like, you know, 3D printed part, welded part, machined part, you know, wiring, and you know, it's all done here. It's all done in house. Everyone did
sick
their share. And you know, this is the outcome.
The fact that like there was so much wiring and it's all fit in there and tucked away nicely is like,
remember how big, how messy it was on the table, but you know, there it's all inside. It all came together nicely.
It's nice because like everything is in one area and you know, just to remind the viewers that this is like removable, so it's supposed
to. Maybe some of the viewers might wonder, like, why some of the wires look like, you know, look some sort of like a mess, or like not completely covered. We did that because if we want to change anything in the future, you know, we don't have to go and cut up a shrink tubing or anything. You know, everything is accessible. We can modify it. We can, and it's already protected, and I've already changed a few pins a few times.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, because you know, because we added the expander later on.
Yeah.
You know, that kind of, you know, gave us.
Now you have all the channels you need.
Oh yeah. You can never have all the channels you need. It's always one more. You know that.
You can build expander B here.
Yeah, we can add, I think, another one or two. I'm not really sure.
Mm-hmm.
But if we have to, yeah, we'll do that. But for right now, with the V6, no turbos or no extra stuff. We don't actually need that. Maybe when we do the Hemi swap, we might need.
No Hemi swap.
Why no Hemi swap?
GTR swap. Hello world, it's Illuminate. Toast to
living like I'm supposed to. Same kid from that basement on that. The gallons of fuel like drunk.
Hey, that'll clean you right out. You'll be on the toilet all night.
Why don't you do it?
Nah.
I was on the toilet all last week.
Alabama shit. We got no fuel. They just got to siph that thing out and put it in our truck. Old edition of Pro Tools. Now I'm living. I make a living. I'm doing what I love and everything was written in stone. Now my women are fitted in clothes. The fifth are in vogue.
Living great, make no mistake. There were times I didn't have a lot of hope. Old friends trying to shoot me down, and new friends are trying to steal my soul. I knew it then what I know now. That's to give a lot and never kill the gold. And I'ma kill a lot just to get the gold. Swear to God, I was made for this. On some major shit, but I've been doing all that.
That's insane, man. It's only gonna get bigger and better from here, boys.
Okay, ignition.
Wanna punch it?
Like, yeah. Seriously, bro. Like, you too, bro. I mean, you did everything, but good job, man. Seriously. I know you are. And this guy's been working late hours just constantly on this build for the wiring. So, huge thank you to Majid, everyone at SMS. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you, boss. All of you guys. Arjun has been helping out with some of the footage as well. Thank you guys so much for staying here. Yeah, they should have went home a couple of hours ago, but everyone stayed here. And to the big boss, big daddy. Mr. King, you guys got your hair done already?
Yeah, hair done.
You know, need to check. All right, guys. Well, that's it from the whole gang. These guys have been working endless hours for this thing to start. And today it has started and it sounds sick. Thanks to all of you guys. So, I mean, I really appreciate all this work you guys
have
done.
Was it worth the wait or what?
It was definitely worth the wait. You guys also tell me if it was worth the wait. Make sure to let us know down in the comment sections. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.
Hey, and you have to know, the action is yet to begin.
Take care, man. Adios. Yo, Casper's alive. Let's do it again for Casper. Like, okay, start it up. Cut off. Da, 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 da.
No. He's like accelerator. Come here.
Accelerator.
I own you.
All right, man.
Amazing, man. Fellas, man. Amazing job to the guys. Amazing job to everything. It finally happened. So, it's good news.
All right, man. I'm going to give you a call in a sec.
All right, man. Yeah, love. Peace.
Peace, man.